Vande Guru Padadandam Bhakta Bindasamanitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Vande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda 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 Vande Radhika Charanodayam Gopi Jano Samayuktam Bindavanam Manoha Vancha Kalpataru Vashaki Pasindu Bevacha Patitanam Pavane Bhavishnavibhyo Namo Nama Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangunglam Haitagirim Yat Kipatam Hangabandhi Paramananda Vadavam Brindavai Tulsidev Vai Vyavai Kesavasacha Shina Bhakti Pade Devi Sattva Vatvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Narancaiva Narottamam Devin Swaraswatiṃ Vyasam Tato Jayo Madire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadhanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukto Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Baranyo Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishtaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam Vitatiham Panatapal Bhavati Bhutam Bande Mahapurusate Charna Ravindam Yat Pada Pallavana Kachandamani Chataya Bispurji Takimapikabodushva Darshi Purna Nuragar Sasagar Saramurti Saradhikamai Kadakivam Karushi Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare, Hare. Ajanulambita bhujau kanaka vadato, sanketanai kapitaro kamala yataksha. Visham baro dijavaro jugadhar mapalo bande yagat priyakaro karuna bhataro Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Namami Gange Tava Pad Pankajam Sura Surair Bandito Dibbarupam Bhuktin Chamuktin Chadada Sinitam Bhavanurupen Sada Naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamananga madapuharam Varanasi purapati bhajavi shanatham Vagi Shajusha Vadane Lakshmir yasya cha bhakshasi yasya asti hidaya sambhid pam shingamaham bhaji Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Advaita Vidhipatikai Rupasaha Sananda Singhasana Labdha Diksha Hatena Kenapi Bayam Satena Dasikrita Gupavadu Bitena Adaita Bithi Patikai Rupasaha Sananda Singhasana Labdha Diksha Hatena Kenapi Bayam Satena Dasikrita Gupavadu Bitena Gauri Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, if we are going to enjoy full kipa mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava, then be sure we are going to get the kipa of Supreme Lord. Gauriya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, suppose you are going to get full kripa of pure Guru Vaishnava, then be sure you are enjoying the kripa of Supreme Lord. Because the kripa of Supreme Lord not directly coming to us, always coming via Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava. That is why Prabhupada very often used to say, Brahmanda Bhramite Kono Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Bij. Without Guru Vishnu Kipa, nobody can cross over this material ocean. Impossible. Without Kipa of Guru Vishnu, nobody can cross over this material ocean, impossible. Because Baddha Jeev, Tatastha Jeev, you know, it is impossible for Tatastha Jeev to cross over the material ocean. Not possible. That's why our direct association, sometime if we are not going to get the chance to get the association of pure Guru Vaishnava directly, but indirectly we can try to get. Prabhupada speaking, we can get the association of those our Guru Varga, Chaitanya Parshad, all their behavior, their etiquette, mutual behavior, everything there, all Siddhanta Vichar we can go through Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Charitamrita. We can get their association, though they came 500 years back. Still, it is possible. It is possible to get the association. Association means affinity. I am doing satsanga all the time, but I have no affinity for sadhu sangha, no attraction. Then it is not sadhu sangha. Follow. Suppose you are getting satsanga, but for satsanga you have no attraction from inside, you have no attachment. In that case, it is not. Sangha means asakti. We should get affinity, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Sango jo sangsitir heto asasya vihito dhiya sa eva sadusu krataha mukshadaram apavritam. Sangho jo sangsitir heto ho. All countless sangha, for infinite period we are doing. This kind of sangha is the cause of our material bondage. Sangho jo sangsitir heto ho, asasya vihito dhiya. Asat means not eternal, material. If you are going to do association, material association in the name of Sadhu Sangha, in the name of Sadhu Sangha, in the name of hearing Harikatha, in the name of take up Mahaprasad, all the time you are doing Asat Sangha. In that case, we cannot expect that our consciousness can go high. Sangho yo sangsete, very, very scientific. How to do this? So fine, you know, judgment, that if you make mistake, then whom to blame? Whom to blame? Bonded soul, 100%, anyhow, anytime, they can make asasanga. But if they have strong faith in Prabhupada and Guru Bhargava, strong affinity for Harikatha, Satsanga, then I can give guarantee. No question of Satsanga. No question of Asasanga. They cannot fall down. Day by day consciousness can grow. All the time. So in the name of Satsanga, in the name of Harikatha, Satsanga, Mahaprasad, if we do wrong, then you will have to get punishment for that, what to do. Sangho ja sangsete rheto asasya vihito dhiya sa eva sadhu sukritaha makshadaram apavritam. The kind of sangha we are doing, it is definitely we are going to arrange bondage in our own life. But that sangha, if we are going to do with jivan mukta purush sadhu sangha, then we can get free from bondage. No. Follow. Nibritta nitaram bhuman asadindiya tarsanat jeno sambhasya maneno prapanyandham tamaha prabhu. Follow, what is it? Manu putri, the daughter of Manuji Maharaj, Devahuti is speaking in front of son Kapil Muni, but she is not going to think that he is son. He think Nibritta Nitaram Bhuman. Bhuman means Bhumapurush. Bhumapurush meaning Bhagavan. Paratpara Akhileshwar. Though she know that Kapilji Maharaj is my son, but never think that way, because now she is going to get free from Maya. Now she like to get free of Maya. She is just fed up of all material enjoyment done in her life. Enough of it. This enough of it, this question, this word, should come. Enough of it. But we can never speak enough of it. This is the main question. Nibritta nitaram bhuman asatindiya tarsanat jeno sambhasya maneno prapanyandham tamaha prabhu. Hey Prabhu, now I fall down into Maya. Andha tama. Tama mean ignorant. Nibrita nitaram. I am just fed up. Whole day and night, all my sense organ wanted to demand. I wanted to supply them their respective demand. But still today, I cannot satisfy them. That is a tragedy. Nobody can satisfy. That's why you can remember I told, no yatu kamaha kamanam upabhogena sammati. Previous topics I was discussing, can remember? Jajati speaking. Hmm? No yatu kamaha kamanam upovogena sammati. Havisha vatmaivo. Havisha Krishna vatmaivo. Bhuyo evavi vardhate. Those sense organs like fire, glowing fire. If you go on adding clarified butter, ghee, then you cannot expect the fire to get extinguished. How you can extinguish fire? Impossible. Because you are going to add fuel to fire. This way, I was bound to discuss that way, you know, from, by the example I took from Bhagavatam. And now here, Kapilji Maharaj, in front of Kapilji Maharaj Bhagavan, Devahuti Ma, Mother Devahuti speaking, Nibritta Nitaram Bhuman Asadindiya Tarsanat. Asat, this all my sense organ not eternal, all asat material, and all their demand, you know, going to put me in trouble. They are never satisfied. I wanted to supply everything, all their demands. But still today they are not getting saturation point. They are not satisfied. So I am just fed up. Nibritta nitaram bhuman asatindiya tarsanat. Tarsan mean trishna. Thirsty attitude. Asatindiya tarsanat. Jeno sambhasya maneno. I wanted to satisfy them all the way, and now I fall down into tama, agyani grahant, maya. Nibrita nitaran bhuman, asadindiya tarsanat. Jeno sambasumane no prapanyandhan tama prabhu. Now please you save me. Without the association of direct Guru Vaishnava Sangha is also necessary, you see. Is very important. And before getting the association of Guru Pad Padma, Vaishnava Sangha, we must get established in Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva. Otherwise, again we can make mistake. Before getting the association of Guru Vaishnava, we must understand Harikatha first. What is the exact tattva? Accurately we have to feel from heart. Then and only then we can get facility. Otherwise, out of emotion, if I run here and there to get sadhu sangha, it can bring danger in my life. Direct communication with Guru Pātpa is 100% necessary. Not that after Diksha, we are flying. Diksha done, they are running. Baba speaking, after taking they are running. They have no connection with him. So, those who are exalted devotees, like Bhavan Goswami, this, that, you can go through their lives, you can find, you can realize. Those who are big, big devotees, surely they have direct connection. You know, you cannot find that direct connection, but they have direct connection. With Prabhupada, Guru Varga, they have direct, that's why they are so powerful. We should have direct communication with Gurudev. Those who are less interested to render Guru Seva, Vaishnava Seva, they are going to fail. They cannot come out. Direct communication with Guru is the first step to the path, on the path of divine service. Guru is to be served in every entity. Direct communication with Guru is the first step on the path of divine service. Guru is to be served. Follow. If Guru is not served, no one can be really, no one can be really served. I must not hear anything till I am authorized to hear by my divine Guru Padma, Gurudev, Prabhupada speaking. Follow. Direct connection with Guru. So now we are again coming to our original point to discuss. But this discussion is also very, very typical discussion. Very minutely we'll have to hear. Otherwise we cannot understand. Bonded soul, their condition, how. So, Nibritta Nitaram Bhuman Asanindya Tarsanat Jeno Sambhasamanino Prapanyandham Tamaha Prabhu. So you please send me. Devahuti Ma, Mother speaking. Anyway, we cannot get bhakti if we are not going to get satsanga. Krishna bhakti janmamul hoy sadhu sanga. Krishna prem janane teo hoy mukshanga. Even in the way of Krishna bhakti, the root cause of Krishna bhakti is sadhu sanga. Also, in the way of getting Krishna prema, this is also a vital point. Now, in Jaiva Dharma 19th chapter, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that in Jiva there is some power, Tatasya Saktina. Jiver je nijo shakti ache, a Jiva surely have some power, Saktina, Tatasya Sakti. And that Jiva, Jiva Sakti, I mean Tatasya Sakti, I mean inside Anuchaitanya Jiva, there is also power. But together with that, if Krishna Kippa or Bhakta Kippa is not there, then it is impossible. I mean, already Jiva Sakti, Tatasya Sakti, Jiva, Anuchaitanya is there. I mean, Sakti is somewhat energy is there. Sakti is there. Jiva Sakti. But together with that, if Krishna Kippa or Bhakta Kippa, if going to get, then there is a chance to develop Sarup Sakti Vritti. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Then there can be the possibility of developing Sarup Sakti Vritti inside the Jiva, Bhakti Sarup Udita Hai. Follow. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Jaiva Dharma, 19th chapter, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that in Jiva surely some Sakti is there, Jiva Sakti, Tatasya Sakti, Jiva Sakti. But together with that, if Jiva going to get Krishna Kippa or Bhakta Kippa, both, then Bhagavan's Sarup Sakti Vritti can develop inside her. In that case, Bhakti Sarup Udita Hai. All the condition of bonded soul, I mean body, speech, mind, sense organ, all material, Bhaktivinoda speaking. The body of Jiva, Jiva getting one body, na? All the body, speech, mind, sense organ, all everything at present, all material. No possibility here. But by, I already told, inside Jiva, Vidya and Avidya both there, even in Bengali Katha there, in Syarapuli, in Devananda Guru Maharaj, I was speaking, that inside Jiva, eternally, Vidya and Avidya both there. That's why in Gita, I already discussed in Gita Hari Katha, Uddharet Atmana Atmanam. You will have to help yourself first. Follow what I say. I explained. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if jivatma going to help herself. Jivatma means strilinga, feminine gender. Shio vivek shakti dara, somewhat consciousness there vivek. If jeev try to move right way, then all material relation, gyan, viragru, shush, you know, when jeev somehow try to drive herself in right direction by little consciousness there, vivek, in that case, jaro sambandhiya material, then jaro sambandhiya gyan, then material gyan going to climb excellent level, and vairagya, preliminary vairagya of shushko, dry vairagya develop. Dry vairagya, because not related with Bhagavad Seva. So now diver, first of all, which we find in the life of, you know, Billa Mangal Thakur. I can discuss. Rupa Goswami Pad giving example, Rasamita Sindhu. So, somehow, somewhat, if Jiva is going to guide herself with little consciousness there, in that case, then Agyan, knowledge, you know, material knowledge related, materially related gyan, not pure gyan, or at the same time some the detachment develop. Shushko, dai vairagya. Bhakti Vidhi, Bhakti Mantra speaking, Bhakti Vritti, Bhakti Vikti, the natural function of jiva, cannot develop by that time. Bhakti Vritti, natural function, Bhakti Vritti, Bhagavad Seva, cannot develop. By the Sarup Shakti of Krishna, if the Sarup Shakti of Krishna, if develop inside heart, little bit, Kriyavati Hele, then gradually that Jivatma can get the chance to develop Shuddha Bhakti, desire of Sati, Vritti, Shuddha Bhakti, then can develop. In that case can develop Shuddha Bhakti, gradually can go on developing Shuddha Bhakti. That is the procedure, otherwise not. Anytime, every time, we can get Bhakti, not that. This matter, you will have to buy satsanga, sadhusanga, everything. You'll have to wait for that. Actually, in Rasamrita Sindhu, Rupa Goswami Pada writing, Utpanno ratayoho sammak noir vignam anupagataha. Krishna sakshat kritau yajnaha sadhakaha parikirtitaha. Utpanna ratayo. They are already developing some rati. Some bondage are trying to do bhajan. Doing bhajan. And Rupa Goswami was speaking, suppose utpanna ratayo already developed some rati, but not going to avoid problem totally. Problem means obstruction, barrier, vigna, impediments, not going to cut. Different kind of impediments still there. But rati developed somehow. Rupa Goswami was speaking, utpanna ratayoho sammak nirvignam anupagataha. Nirvigna, I mean flawless, problemless bhajan not developed as yet. There is still some problem, barrier, impediments. So, utpanna ratayoho sammak nirvignam anupagataha. Anupagataha means not come, not yet received, that kind of stage. Krishna sakshat kritau yajnaha. Sadhakaha parikirtita. Who is sadhak? About sadhak, I was discussing so many things you can remember. I was discussing long, long time, you can remember. Prabhupada also used to give the example from Bhaktisiddhanta Sindhu. Iha yasso harer dasse karmana manasa gira nikhillasyo opi avasthasu jivan muktaha sa uchyate. Rasamrita Sindhu, Purva Vibhag. Rasamrita Sindhu, Bhaktisiddhanta, jivan mukto. What is the symptom of jivan mukto? In living condition, they are free. They are totally liberated. Jivan mukto. His condition, Prabhupada very often used to discuss. What is that? Bali, iha, jasso harer dasse, karmana manasa gira, nikhilasyo opi avasthasu jivan mukto sa uchyate. Meaning of this sloka, I mean the meaning, that in at all condition, if a jiva developing a serving mood by speech, body and mind, always ready to serve Krishna, dasya. Follow what I say. Any condition, he is always ready to serve. Spriha, chesta, serving mood. If you find in any jiva, be sure he is jivan mukta. In living condition, he is free, liberated. Jivan mukta purush. Very excellent. Now I come back to the sloka I was discussing. Utpanna ratayoho sammak nairvignam anupagataha. Krishna sakshat kritau yajnaha sadhakaha parikirtita. Bhakti Asamitsa. Rupa Goswami wanted to speak, those who are going to develop some Krishna Rati, but not going to avoid total flaw, not going to develop total flawless bhajan, some problem, impediments there. Not totally they are going to avoid all problems is there. But still, they have now, but still, if they have not done any aparad unto the lotus feet of Asraya Vigraha and Visaya Vigraha. Very minutely you will have to hear. Follow what I say. Those who are developing Rati, but still today they, all their problems is not over from their life. Some sort of problems there. But still, they have not done any aparad unto the lotus feet of Asraya Vigraha, I mean Guru Pad Padma, Guru Vishnav, and Visaya Vigraha Bhagavan. They have not done any aparad. That's why Rupa Goswami was speaking, someday they can get the Sakshatkar, they can meet Krishna in dream or anyhow. Krishna Sakshatkar Yoga. They can get Sakshatkar. Somehow they can get. Their yoga means they can get money, they can 100% ignore that. They are qualified. Somehow. In dream, this, that, somehow they are qualified. And Rupa Goswami was speaking, they are actually sadhak. They are actually sadhak. And about sadhya sadhana tattva, I was discussing from Rasamrita Sindhu long ago, you can remember, maybe 1-2 months ago. Kriti sadhya bhavet sadhya bhava sa sadhana vidha nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakatyam ridhi sadhyata. This sloka finally I will have to discuss. Otherwise I cannot draw final conclusion. Nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakatyam ridhi sadhyata. What is nitya sadhyasya? Eternally present in the sarup and the nature of jiv, that I can discuss finally. So, kriti sadhya, bhavet sadhya bhava, sadhya bhava, kriti sadhya. Or by the help of sense organs, you will have to, you know, try Bhakti, we can see bhakti in applied form, you know, by the help of your sense organ, kiti saddha, bhavet saddha, bhava, sa sadhana vidha. That is called sadhana bhakti. About nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakattam hiti saddhata. Sadhana bhakti means you will have to, what is eternally present, you will have to develop. You have to get manifested inside your heart. Saddha bhav bhakti, when can be applied through sense organs, indriya, saddha hai, then it is sadhana bhakti. And nitya siddha bhav through bhajan to bring, to get manifest in life is saddhata. But for I am doing sadhana. Now I can go back to the previous law. Here it is written, Rupa Goswami was speaking, they are qualified to get darshan of Krishna. That doesn't mean they can get. They are qualified. If Krishna likes, they can get. So, Rupa Goswami was giving example, Billa Mangal Tullo Je Sadakahaste Prakirtitaha. Rupa Goswami was speaking, a Billa Mangal Thakur, like being about Billa Mangal Thakur, those are sadhaka stekitita, they are sadhaka. That doesn't mean when Billa Mangal Thakur writing, his name, Billa Mangal Thakur, what Mahaprabhu used to enjoy all day and night, follow. Karnamrito, Krishna Karnamrito. That when developing that stage, that is different actually, we can discuss. So sadhak, Rupa Goswami is going to compare with this, that is called sadhak. So, now point is that, when Rupa Goswami was going to give this example of Billa Mangal Thakur, Billa Mangal Tulla Je Sadakaha Ste Prakirtitaha. Why? The previous case of Billa Mangal Thakur. Previously, he was full of karma, big problem, follow. He was full of material karma. His attention was very dirty. But after that, somehow when he developed detachment, dry detachment. Just now I discussed from Jaiva Dharma, Bhaktivinoda Thakur discussion, you know. Just now, for 10 minutes before I was discussing, the jiva, they have some shakti. Jiva-shakti means tato-sasa-shakti is there. And together with that, Krishna-kripa and Bhakta-kripa, if going to add, then Sarup-shakti-vritti can develop. Then Bhakti-sarup can develop inside. At present, all the body, mind, speech, sense organ, all material. Somehow, if jiva, a little consciousness is there, if somehow can drive herself towards right direction, then somehow in first stage can develop materially related knowledge, not pure knowledge, and detachment, which is dry detachment, follow. After that, you know, because in that case, bhakti-vritti cannot develop. When, as and when Krishna sarup-shakti-vritti going to develop inside heart somehow, kiyat-parimane, become active inside the heart of that devotee, then suddha bhakti-vritti can develop. And many times I told, the question of yukta-vairagya is very important to protect yourself. Otherwise, you cannot keep balance. Sometimes you can flow, in the stream of enjoyment, or some other time you can flow in the flow of detachment. Both detachment and enjoyment we should discard, we should throw away. Enjoyment we do need, non-nirvinno nati shakta bhakti yoga asya siddhida. I told many times, Prabhupada used to say, non-nirvinno, he is not fed up. And not going to hate. Non-nirvinno nati shakta, but attachment is also not there. Then bhakti yoga can come out successful in his life. Yukta Vairagya is so fine demarcation. Like I was discussing about Tatastha Sakti, na is fine demarcation you cannot find. So fine demarcation is impossible. You cannot understand. I can give one example. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, again I can come back to the original point. Yukta Vairagya, what is Yukta Vairagya? You should understand. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagat Guru, one day going to give order to one of his bhakta, you go and buy one very costly, shoe for Bana Maharaj. Follow? And he is going to buy one very costly shoe for Bana Maharaj, for preaching. But then, Prabhupada speaking, you go and give this shoe to Bana Maharaj and ask him that Maharaj, Prabhupada, requesting you to come here with the shoe. But Bana Maharaj feeling shy. Again, Prabhupada giving order, you come. You ask Bana Maharaj to come in front of me with a shoe. Then Maharaj coming. Then Prabhupada laughing and speaking. Now come on. It's called Yukta Vairagya. Now you are going to renounce. Now today you are going to renounce your renunciation. Now you are going to renounce your renunciation. Now you are going to renounce even your renunciation. What use? What use? Vairagya, what use? If I cannot serve Krishna, if I cannot serve Gauranga, Guru Bharga, what use of my Vairagya? What I can do with it? But Billamangal Thakur couldn't realize fast. It is Leela. I never want to prove that Billamangal Thakur is bonded so. Because Guru Bharga giving judgment so fine. So, detachment and attachment, in between there is a fine demarcation, Yukta Vairagya, we should realize. Like Tatastha Sakti, you should realize. So fine demarcation, you cannot locate any position where the Tatastha line is there in this infinity Brahmanda where you can go and find all Bhadra Jivas there. Because Tatastha point is Nirvishesh point. Jiva can never stay in Tatastha condition. Either they can enjoy, jump into enjoyment, or they can jump into Krishna Seva. Tatastha position, though externally and imaginary, was still very effective. This, terminology is very important, without which all philosophy is useless. It's fine existence there, which we cannot. We cannot see. Now I can prove here also. Like yesterday I was speaking about Ajamil. I was bound to give this example. Ajamil was not 100% material. Somewhat some consciousness was already there. He was favorable to Guru Vaishnava, elderly person, senior devotee, father, mother. He used to serve. He used to worship Salagram. In the meantime, he is going to meet with some Maya, which is impossible for bonded soul to overcome. sufficient chitball is if sufficient chitball is not there with you, anyhow, anywhere you say, anytime you can be in problem. Follow what I say. Chitball, sufficient chitball means Guru Kipa, Vaishnav Kipa, chitball, if sufficient chitball is not there, anytime you can fall down. So be careful. Your dry philosophy cannot, all your bhajan power, direct bhajan power you need. Guru Kipa, Vaishnav Kipa. Then you can protect yourself, otherwise you cannot protect. Now point is that, Ajamil was not 100% material. Ajamil was somehow some consciousness was there, as Bhaktivinoda Thakur already described. But chitball was not sufficient, that's why he was bound to fall down in Maya. He fell down in Maya. Now to fall down in Maya, somehow he was in positive direction, like I was discussing about keeping zero in middle, right side you can go on writing 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, zero in middle, positive integer, and keeping zero in middle, if I go to negative direction, leftward, then -1, -2, -3, -4, this way I can go. So anyway, if you like to go to negative direction from positive direction, somehow, you will have to cross over this zero. There is no other way. Zero is the middle. Zero is nothing, not there. Zero is something which is very valuable. Similarly, when Ajamil was a little bit in positive direction, he is now going to fall down in Maya. So surely, unknowingly, he is going to cross over this, you know, tatastha position. Tatastha position. I am not going to serve Krishna, not going to be attracted by Maya. Practically, you cannot find. In Jiva, Bhaktivinoda already told yesterday. In fine form, the tatastha bhava is already there in Jiva. But practically, you cannot locate in infinity Brahmanda. There is some place that is marginal space where you can. It is philosophically scoot. And like ideal gas, someday I can, if you understand physics, chemistry, I like to discuss someday, Kelvin scale and ideal gas. Actually, practically, ideal gas is not available. In whole world, we can say it is one yardstick, standard, we fix up to calculate. Follow. Maybe in student life, you go through Avogadro hypothesis, so many things, maybe you forget today. So to Ajamil, already Bhaktivinoda Thakur told that Jiva Tatastha Bhava is there in fine form inside Sarup, not practically. So you see, Ajamil now going to fall down in Maya, so surely From positive direction, he is going to jump into Maya. So surely he is going to cross over this zero, this tatastha position, demarcation there. Billamangal Thakur also, you can find. Billamangal Thakur, first developing tremendous material Maya. Then now, by the advice of that cross, you know, Chinta Manir Jayati, this sloka I can discuss next day. I can show you. So anyway, when you feel, when he is going to feel some detachment, but still, follow, try to, why Rupa Goswami Pada is going to give this example? Why Rupa Goswami Pada is going to give this example? Try to understand. Pillamangal Thakur, that night, somehow torrential rain and wind going on, Billamangal Thakur crossing the river, somehow going to get into, you know, he wanted to get the association of that cross, and there was a big wall all around, and there was one big snake, python, Billamangal Thakur thought it is the arrangement of Krishna. I am getting one thread and catching the tail and going to jump in, going to climb and then finally jump into that area of, you know, into the area of that Chintamani pros. And Chintamani going to, she is going to hear one big sound, doom! What happens? He's going to get the lantern and going with umbrella, going to check. Oh, it's Billamangal, Silhan Mishra. His name was Silhan Mishra. Eh? He is knowing Sanskrit, so many big pandit, but now Maya. Silhan Mishra. His name was Silhan Mishra. Now somehow she is trying to get that man inside room. He gone faint. He was in faint condition. After getting consciousness, Chintamani going to speak heavily. You foolish idiot! Eh? This kind of attraction you have for my body? If you can develop this kind of attachment for Krishna, you can get Krishna. Foolish! Oh my God! You take risks. Eh? You take risks. Big risks. To kill yourself. Then and there, Silhan Mishra developed detachment and gone from that home. Follow. Chintamani Jayati, this Chintamani is not that pros. Here Chintamani, it seems, is going to speak about that. No, that Chintamani means Krishna. Krishna is also Chintamani. In sloka, somebody going to speak wrongly. Chintamani pros. But anyway, she wanted to chastise Silhan Mishra. Then and there, he developed detachment and gone. But already I told, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, in that case, somehow they are developing some dry vairagya and material knowledge is not pure. I mean, there is every possibility for him to put himself in danger again. Follow what I say. See, develop detachment, you know, is going, somehow that doesn't mean problem over. Again, he's going to meet with problem. One city, he gone, there was one beautiful, you know, lady. She was taking bath and is a wife of somebody, but she is a very conscious lady. And Billamangal Thakur actually wanted to express his desire to enjoy again. Then, you know, the husband of that, you know, lady, you know, he went to, because that time Billamangal Thakur was looking like sadhu. So they want, okay, husband allow. Then that time when that lady coming in front of Silhan Mishra, Silhan Mishra was disgusted. He was thinking, I cannot check myself until the last, until the last, you know, moment of my life. So it is good if I can blind, if I can make myself blind. Then he is going to ask for one, you know, some, you know, throne, kata, with clip. They are using, that time they are using for controlling here. Mataji is there. Then, he is going to, you know, make himself blind. He is so much disgusted, I cannot check myself, so great karma. Then and there, Chaitanya Guru somehow become favorable. And from then, turning point, Billamangal Thakur developed detachment, actual detachment, and by Sadhu Sangha going to get, you know, Advaita Vidipati Koi. First of all, he developed dry vairagya, Advaita Vidipati Koi, Rupasyo, Ananda Singhasana Labda Diksha, Hateno Kenapi Bayam Satena Dasikrita Gopavatu Gopavadhu Vitena. When I was first interested in the way of Advaita Mark, this way, and I wanted to climb a throne which is going to give me honor and prestige, but still, somehow, by the mercy of Krishna, somehow, I was bound to change my mood and everything. I became a maid servant of that Krishna. You know, follow. This way. So now my question is that, when Billamangal Thakur, you know, from this Maya, follow, from negative side, Billamangal Thakur coming to positive side. I mean, Seva Mark. In that case, also knowingly, unknowingly, Billamangal Thakur going to cross this neutral point that is called Tatastha position. Tatastha position means it is nirvishesh position. No mood of self. Actually, for Baddha Jibo, it is not possible. And when they are doing bhajan, going there, climb, you know, Brahma, attainment of Brahma, that is separate. But usually Baddha Jiva in this, you know, in this world, material world, this is not possible. Tatastha Sati, one nirvishesh position. Bonded soul can either jump into Krishna Seva or jump into Maya. In between there, imagine there is one fine demarcation. Follow what I say. This way, Rupa Goswami Pada is going to give this example. Rupa Goswami Pada is going to give this example very nicely. And the topics I wanted to speak, that Prabhupada speaking to Bana Maharaj, today you are going to renounce your renounce order. You are going to renounce your renunciation. You know, renunciation. So, we are interested about Yukta Vairagya. Now, I like to read some letter. So many letters coming, but the most important letter sent by one of my son from Slavonia. So I like to read it, and I like to give answer on the basis of that. And after that, the discussion can go on so long, because this letter I am going to read vital points. Vital points. You know. One time one devotee was asking about on internet, and he was bound to reply something. A sannyasi, anyway. Now, he is a disciple of somebody, actually sannyasi. So, that Maharaj told him, I mean my son, he told him that this description, about is actually not true. Because karma, I like to read from beginning again. And all. Acha. I was asking you something about Tatastha Sakti and Anadi Karma. But perhaps that time, I could not express myself very clearly, and also you were in a bit brisk hurry, so it remained unclear to me. So now I will try to express more clearly. I have directly heard from my Gurudev, I mean Bhaktivala Tithukashi Maharaj, that Jiva is Tatastha Sakti which means it is situated between spiritual line and material, spiritual world and material world. I already answer very clearly. And can by her relative independence, free will, go either side? Follow, try to. It is, you know, the philosophy you should understand. But just like the argument given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Just like the argument given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You can remember. Yesterday also I was speaking about this point. What is that point? That point is there. That tasso ba etasso purushasso de eva stane bhavato idancha paraloko stanancha sandhyam tritiyam sapnastanam tasmin sandhisthane tishtan eti ubhisthane pasudi idancha paraloko stanancha brihat aranyaka upanishad. Another sloka, brihat aranyaka 4.3.18. Tad yatha mahamatso ubhe kule anu sancharati purvancha paranchaivam paranchaivam evam purusha eto ubhau eto ubhau antvanu san anu sancharati sapnantanja buddhantanja. This slope. This means that Purusha, I mean Jivatma, is going to option. This Jivatma, I mean that Jivatma is called Purusha, Jiva Purush, having two place. One is material world and Chit Jagat. And that Jivatma is situated in the marginal position, it is, you know, sandhasthan, it is just like dream, you know, is staying there and watching both sides, somehow going to feel attraction to a material world, can jump, somehow going to feel attraction to a material world, a transcendental world can jump, some going to feel attraction to a material world can jump, and some going to feel attraction to transcendental kingdom. Also, this example, next example, it is just like a fish in a big river, swimming, sometime going that side of river, sometime coming this side of river. It's kind of conception giving example. Now, point is there, this philosophy given very nicely, so that we can understand. But in which case this is applicable? Because if we locate one position, tatastha position, as given this example, then at all can be there can be possibility to jump into maya, jump into chit jagat. But at all, for bonded soul it is written, what is the situation, when and how it is applicable, that we should understand. Whereas I already discussed, tatastha position is, you know, the fine form, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also told. So when it is applicable? Theoretically, if we can understand, that is very good. If this example is not there, is very difficult for us to understand. Follow. These things, I already give some two examples about Billa Mangal Thakur, about Ajamil. Is it applicable already? Already it is for bonded soul. Already bonded. Because Anadi Bahirmukh mean, Krishna Bhuli Sayji, Anadi Bahirmukh, here one point coming. Very analytically you will have to understand. Anadi Bahirmukh means there is no time of starting. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur already declared, within the frame of material time, we cannot find any starting point. That's why we say Anadi. Now point is there, if there is material time, if there is material time in this material world, we can apply material time. If at all this material time is not applicable, then what time applicable? Then surely eternal time is applicable. Nitya Vartaman, eternal present. Because two time factors, one is eternal present, then in eternal world, and one is material time. So if material time is not applicable, then which time applicable? Which time applicable? Eternal time applicable. So actually, Krishna Boli Seijib Anadi Bohirmukh, and also yesterday I was discussing that those jivas coming from directly from the body of Baladev Nityananda, they are Nitya Mukta, they are busy with Seva, they have never seen any material sansar, they have no conception about material sansar, nothing. There is a conception. Follow what I say. And from the Tatastha Shakti, those jivas coming, they can never be compared with those jivas, those who are coming from Balaji Maharaj. So eternally they are present, they are doing seva, nitya kal, nitya mukta. So we can get another group of jiva, infinity number of jiva, coming from Tatastha Shakti. Follow. Eternally, they are bonded. Previous, those jivas, those who are coming from Sankarshan, eternally free, and they are eternally bonded. And if we are going to express some doubt about Krishna, that why Krishna doing this? Why from Tatastha, position, Shakti, these jivas coming, they are all eternally bonded. Nitya Sansar. If there is no thief, no dacoit, what is the utility of police? Follow, try to understand. If there is no dacoity, no thief, nothing, no robbery, nothing, then what is the utility of police? I already told, Krishna is full of infinity. Krishna is full of infinity diversity. We cannot blame Krishna. Itself, infinity pure. Krishna is full of infinite, full of infinity diversity. And why Krishna going to make infinity diversity? That question I cannot put. It is one game already written in Shastra. Krishna feeling, why Krishna going to feel this kind of game? Man, game is game. Why Krishna playing? This question is, why small boys playing? If you put question in front of small boy, hey, why you are playing? Are we like to play, that's why playing. Krishna is always with sportive nature. And in transcendental world, eternal Vrindavan, there is also Krishna is sportive nature. And Krishna is also going to play with this creation, vast infinity creation with all jivas. Actually, there is no profit and loss account. Why Krishna going to play with this bonded soul? Why Krishna going to make them? Infinity purity is there. No starting point. Already there. So, actually, in that case, what happens, you know, this, you know, Krishna Boli Seijib Anadi Bohirmukh, Anadi Bohirmukh, this term we find is we are going to apply, like we apply for Ajamil on, you know, Billamangal Thakur I already show you how it is applicable, how they are going to cross, you know, marginal line, Tatastha line and jumping into Maya, and also how Billamangal Thakur from negative position go to this way. Example. So now actually that my son speaking, I have directly heard from my Gurudev, I mean from Bhakti Vallabhtirtha Goswami, he heard that jiva is Tatastha Shakti, which means is situated between spiritual and material world and can by her relative independence Free will is already there. I already told Chetan Vastu means free will, action, everything should be there. Otherwise, Chetan Vastu is useless. If Chetan Vastu having no free will, then what is the utility of the Chetan Vastu? So, I have directly heard from my Gurudev, I mean Bhaktivinoda Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, Jiva is Tatasya Sakti, everybody knows, which means it is situated between spiritual and material world and can by her relative independence, free will, go either side. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking, Jiva having the quality, you know, both, they can go this side, transcendental world, Chinmay Jagat, and can adopt. If Jiva wants to enjoy material world, she will enter into it, getting false ego. False ego can bind her. Because this decision happened on Tathastha plane. I am not speaking. I am reading the letter. Because this decision happened on Tathastha plane. Follow what I say. Which is about material time. It is said that this conditioned jiva is anadi bahirmukha or is doing anadi karma because we cannot find any starting date in material time. So the word anadi is used. Same I also read in Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur's Jaiva Dharma chapter 15 and 16. He is speaking. I am reading the letter. This was clear to me. Then one time one devotee was asking about this on internet and I replied in above manner as I am speaking to you, reading to you. He is speaking, I replied him. Seeing my reply, on reading my reply, one sannyasi is a disciple of some Maharaj told me that this description above is actually not true. True means materially not possible. The ideology is not false, he is not speaking. That sannyasa is speaking, that is your above description as given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, your Guru Maharaj, is not actually true. Because karma is literally anadi, it is without any beginning at all. And that Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur gave such description of anadi karma only as a figurative description so that jivas would not blame God for their suffering, but it actually never happened like that. It is one theoretical example. He is speaking, that sannyasi. Then he quoted commentary by Srila Baladev Vidyabhusan to Vedanta Sutra Govinda Vasya on Sutra 2134, 2135 as evidence and as real explanation of why and how karma is anadi. And my son speaking, I read that, and there Baladev Vidyabhusan wrote that as God is anadi, so is jiva anadi and karma is also anadi, and then he also gives illustration of a seed and sprout as example we find in this world. Kindly please first read this commentary, then you can understand about below man some points he is already giving to me so that I can read and give answer. That sannyasi giving argument with my son is forwarding this letter to me. So this sannyasi said that Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote about anadi karma in Jaiva Dharma cannot be, you know, true because the following reason. Cannot be true means he is not going to insult Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He is going to say that how it is not applicable theoretically, as you know, we can put it as standard, you know, because of following reason. What is the reason? He is speaking, so sannyasi say that Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote about anadi karma in Jaiva Dharma cannot be applicable because the following reasons. What is first point? There cannot be any beginning outside of material time because there everything is eternal. That also I told. One is material time and another time factor we can consider that is eternal time. Nitya Vartaman. So he is giving that sannyasi giving argument to him and he is forwarding these questions to me. Some points, some reasons. There cannot be any beginning outside of material time because there everything is eternal. First point, I already told. Second point, if there would be a beginning of karma, instead of being beginningless, anadi, then God would be blamed of partiality and cruelty based on Sutra 2.1.3.4. Sutra means Vedanta Sutra 2.1.34 and 2.1.35. Because karma is anadi, infinity, we cannot find sense, so we cannot blame Krishna. Second point, try to understand. If there would be a beginning of karma, instead of being beginningless, anadi, then God would be blamed of partiality and cruelty. Based on the Vedanta Sutta Sloka 2.1.34, 2.1.35. Third point, the seed and the sprout example shows that karma is without any beginning at all. Karma always existed. The seed and sprout example shows that karma is without any beginning at all. But seed first or tree first or seed first, no solution. So the seed and sprout example shows that karma is without any beginning at all. Karma always existed for anadikal, either as sprout or as seed during destruction, you know, pralaya, also karma is there. Fourth point is that if jiva really could see material world on one side and Krishna on other side, then that jivatma would definitely choose Krishna, otherwise how Krishna can be called all attractive? Follow what I say. Very nice argument. If jiva really could see, if we imagine in this material Brahmanda, there is one position, Tathastha position. All jivas, they are standing in Tathastha position. If they are going to look this side, Maya, and that side, Krishna. Surely, the attraction of Krishna is going to, you know, prove 100%. Follow what I say. If jiva really could see material world on one side and Krishna on another side, then she would, that jivatma would definitely choose Krishna. Otherwise, how Krishna can be all attractive? Very important point. Number fifth, if at some point jiva didn't have karma, if we take it as granted, some point was there before, when karma was not there with jiva. If at some point jiva didn't have karma, then there would be no ingredients, then there will be no ingredients. Then there would be no ingredients of Mahavishnu creation lila, srishti lila, which is eternally perpetual. Because Mahavishnu is eternal and his breathing out, I mean creation, and breathing in, I mean destruction, pralaya, is also eternal. It has no beginning. Jasaika nisheshito kalo matavalambo jivanti loma vilaja jagadannanatha vishnur mahanasa iho jasu kalavishesho govindam adi purusham tamaham bhajami. If jiva really could see material world one side and Krishna another side, then see, I mean jiva would definitely choose Krishna, otherwise how Krishna can be called all attractive. Number fifth, if at some point jivas did not have karma, then there would be no ingredients for Mahavishnu creation lila, srishti lila, which is eternally perpetual, because Mahavishnu is eternal, his breathing, I mean breathing out, I mean creation is also eternal, his breathing in, destruction, pralaya, is also eternal. It has no beginning. Later on, the devotee speaking, not the sannyasi. Later on, I showed to the sannyasi. Later on, my son speaking to that sannyasi. Later on, I showed to this sannyasi that same Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu also says in the commentary to Sutra 2326. That if jiva turns away from God, her natural, eternal, spiritual consciousness become covered, and if she turns towards God, it is manifested. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking this way. They are bound to give this example. There is no other way. How they can make us understand? We can never understand. Same, he says in his commentary to Bhagavad Gita 15. I told to this sannyasi that this point is based on the verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, as I was discussing yesterday, Bayam Ditya Vinivishata Sat 11.237. Bayam Ditya Vinivishata, I already discussed. Where it is mentioned about Ishad Apetasya, turning away from God as the cause of coming under Mahamaya. And that Kaviraj Goswami quoted also this verse in Chaitanya Charitamrita to give evidence for this verse. Krishna Bulli, Sei Jeev Anadi Vairmukh, Atoyev Mayatare Daya Sansaradi Dukh. So, because Baladev mentioned both points, we have to find reconciliation. So, this sannyasi's reconciliation then was that karma is literally anadi, as mentioned in Vedanta Sutta, without any beginning at all. There was no initial first choice on the part of jiva to either serve Krishna or start karma, material activities. So that Baladev Vidyabhusan said, so what Baladev Vidyabhusan says in Sutra 2326 and Srimad Bhagavatam 11.237 and also in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written about turning towards God or can reject this possibility, I mean turn away from God. This choice was not existing previous to bondage of jiva. This choice was not existing previous to bondage of jiva. Follow. This choice, I mean either can go this side. You know, this choice was not existing previous to bondage of jiva. Because bondage is anadi, beginningless. He also, I mean the sannyasi also gave evidence from Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur's commentary to Srimad Bhagavatam 4.22.32 that Jiva's bondage is spontaneous. Jiva's bondage is spontaneous. It is right. Follow. Jiva's bondage is spontaneous. Now we see the case of Ajamil. Nobody going to force him to jump into Maya. Nobody going to force him to jump into Seva, eternal world, automatically done. So, Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur, from Srimad Bhagavatam 4.22.32, Sloka, wanted to prove that Jiva's bondage is spontaneous, without cause. Nobody going to force. So, now we will have to understand. And also my son going to write some reconciliation. Also I'll have to read. Follow. If I don't read, then it's not good. So now I can try to find out solution out of that on the basis of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Bhakti. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur also writing, I already told there's one article. But first of all, I don't know time can permit me or not, but still I will have to read. If I don't read, it is not good. My son from Slovenia going to give answer to that sannyasi. The sannyasi giving answer this way, and my son going to answer this way. One by one, I am going to read. First, when some Baddha Jiva becomes Sadhan Siddha, then she will enter into eternal Goloka Dhamma. So, although Goloka is eternal and above material time, still there are certain beginnings there. As with this entrance of Sadhan Siddha Jiva, so if Jiva can have her beginning of Seva in Goloka Dhamma, like we see in the description of Gopa Kumar in Brihad Bhagavatamritam, then we cannot say that there cannot be any beginning in eternity, above material time. So, Tathastha plane is also above material time. So, Tathastha plane is also above material time. Here is very spectacular, I will have to give answer to this answer. So Tathastha plane is also above material time. If you think this way, so I have to give answer on this point. So Tathastha plane is also above material time. So there can be beginning there also. The Jiva can choose to either enter into spiritual world or material world. This description of one kind of start and beginning. This decision of one kind of start, beginning, the Jiva can by her decision change her position in eternity. Second argument given by my son, thus the sutra says that if God would do, the sutras say that if God would do specific creation of different positions of Jivas in material world without regard of their action, then He would obviously be partial and cruel. But He didn't. He gives them position in regard to action of Jivas. So if Jiva herself chose to enter into material world from Tathastha plane, then again God is only giving award for her action. So He cannot be blamed. So we cannot say that only if karma of Jiva is without any beginning at all, then God cannot be blamed. In the case of such beginning of karma from tatastha plane, God also cannot be blamed. So it is not contradictory or to the exclusion. Third argument given by him, Sri Krishna says in Gita that third point, Sri Krishna says in Gita that one who will be born will definitely die, and one who dies will definitely born, but this is true only in certain circumstances. Because Krishna later on says that one who will realize Krishna will not take another birth again. So under certain time and circumstances is applicable, he is speaking. So here we cannot say to Krishna that this cannot happen, because already before you said it is certain that one who dies will have to take birth. It means that principle applies only in certain circumstances, not in all cases. So it is the same with seed and sprout example. If we take it literally to prove that there is no any beginning before seed was tree and before tree was seed, etc., then the problem comes with ending karma, because after tree comes seed and after seed comes tree, etc. But we know that karma can stop. Yes, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also told karma can stop. Jo karma is anadi, but still karma can stop in the life of any jiva. So you see, but we know that karma can stop, can be destroyed, if one accepts bhakti. We know it. So this example of seed and tree only illustrates certain principles, how karma is perpetual from one form to another, but it doesn't cover all circumstances. So we cannot firmly use it to say that there cannot be any other circumstances at all, and therefore cannot be any beginning of karma at all. God is omnipotent. He can create seed without existence of its tree before, and he can create a tree without existence of its seed before, and he can fully destroy the seed and the tree itself. So if jiva on tatastha plane choose to enter material world, God can create one tree of karma for her. Why not? He is giving her. And again, he cannot be blamed for that. Fourth point, I heard from my Gurudev that Mahamaya looks very dazzling, attractive on one side. That is why some jivas want to enter there. That is why some jivas want to enter there. Like this, in this world we can see that insects want to enter into fire, being attracted by lights and going to die, or like, you know, so many examples. Krishna is eternal, Mahavishnu is also eternal. We cannot say that Krishna was in existence before Mahavishnu. It is also impossible, really so. Our material brain, I mean, it is my opinion, we always try to apply our brain here. So Krishna is eternal, Mahavishnu is also eternal. We cannot say that Krishna was in existence before Mahavishnu, because both are eternal. But still, it is also said that Krishna is the source, I mean cause of all causes, I mean cause of Mahavishnu also. Goloka Leela is also eternal, and Mahavishnu's Srishti Leela is also eternal, perpetual. Sometime creation, sometime destruction is still going on. It is not that Goloka Leela happens before Srishti Leela, as both are eternal. But still it is said that Goloka is above Srishti Leela. And Srishti Leela is Srishti Leela is the perverted reflection of the Goloka Leela. It is said how it is. So if Jiva can enter into eternal Goloka Leela, why is he cannot enter into Srishti Leela from Tatastha position? But this entrance is not influenced by material time. In material time, we see there is some cause, and then after there is effect. But in spiritual time, eternal present, there is no such material time gapping between cause and effect. That is why Kaviraj Goswami added word anadi in front of bahir mukha to qualify that here there is no influence of material time gap between cause, I mean Krishnavali, and effect, Maya bondage. But still, the factual decision was there by Jiva, but it is anadi. But still, the factual decision was there by Jiva, but it is anadi, above material time. So, those jivas who wanted to enjoy Maya were always there in Srishti Leela, although before they were in Tatastha position. This point is not yet fully clear to me. He is speaking. So please, he is requesting me. So I see that how Srila Baladev Vidyabhushan explained anadi karma in Vedanta is correct, but it covers all certain principles and it doesn't contradict or exclude what Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote in Jaiva Dharma by revealing some further principles. Please forgive me for writing you such a long letter. I wanted to express myself clearly, and why I was asking you that time in Calcutta. So at this time I request you to please see whether my reconciliation has any mistakes, and what would be right Siddhanta on these topics based on your previous guru Bhargava slice Vishwanath Chakravarti Baladev Vidyabhushan priest, is writing this way. So this way, today you try to think over and again about this letter, try to understand, and tomorrow means next Harikatha, I can try to give you so many examples from different writings of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, I can try. to give. Already I give some example, still I can try to establish Siddhanta Bhashya. And Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, actually Prabhupada was in writing one nice article to clarify this position of bonded soul, bonded condition of jiva, marginal position of jiva, and free condition of jivas. Somehow I can explain a little bit, and next Harikatha I can try to explain. Prabhupada speaking, jivas are placed in three different conditions. Jivas are placed into three different conditions, like bonded condition, marginal condition, and free condition, mukta. In Bhagavan itself, these three conditions are resting directly or indirectly. Follow? Maybe 1 year ago, maybe more than 1 year ago, I cannot remember. I was explaining that Tathastha Shakti not directly staying in Krishna. Follow? Achinta Vedavetta according is there relation of Tathastha, Jivas and Bhagavan, but direct existence of Tathastha Shakti is not there inside Krishna. Inside Krishna only Sarva Shakti. I can explain later. Anyway, I am going to speak about what Prabhupada told. Prabhupada speaking, jivas are placed into three different conditions like bonded condition, marginal condition, and free condition, mukta. In Bhagavan itself, these three conditions are resting directly or indirectly. If at all, it is taken as granted that the existence of this bonded condition was not, if at all it is taken as granted that the existence of this bonded condition has not been derived from Supreme Lord, then in that case its existence becomes false. All coming from Krishna. All coming from eternal Krishna. Try to understand. Prabhupada speaking, in Bhagavan itself, these three conditions are resting directly or indirectly. If at all it is taken as granted that the existence of this bonded condition has not been derived from Supreme Lord, then in that case its existence becomes false. Those Mayavadis saying that the materially bonded condition is totally false. Mayavadi speaking. But Bhagavan Sri Krishna Chaitanya Deva has said that this is not at all false, but unstable by nature. Or I mean is affected or destroyed in course of time, but not false. In the real self of Jiva, bondedness is an example of metamorphosis. I mean, to treat or to think this material gross body as Dehi, Atma or soul, is the place of origin of this metamorphosis conception. The lack of this genuine, vast tata gyan is known as metamorphosis, vivartha, is metamorphosis, meaning vivartha. The transformation of Shakti of Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, making this three worlds, I mean this 14 worlds, is compared with one tree. And in Gita also, urdham ulam adho sakam. So, Prabhupada speaking, the transformation of Shakti of Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, making this three, I mean worlds, 14 worlds, Supreme Lord never undergo the influence of these three conditions like bandhet condition, tatastha condition, or free conditions. Moreover, these three stages, bandhet stage, tatastha stage, and free stage, all these three have been derived from Him itself. Supreme Lord, His external potency of Maya Shakti has been transformed as this material world. His internal potency has been transformed as Vaikuntha Jagat or Goloka, all beyond Maya. The eternal potency and the eternal potency in between both of them, there is another potency called Tatastha Shakti, which has been transformed into countless Anu Chaitanya, infinity number of atomic particle, Chit Vastu. Tatastha Shakti, marginal potency, has been transformed as all those countless Anu Chaitanya. Since Anu Chaitanya Jiva is a transformation or Tatastha Shakti, so while in Goloka or Vaikuntha can have the opportunity to enjoying the shelter of, shelter of Antaranga Shakti, internal potency, also while in this material world, then Jivatma can come under the control of Maya Shakti. A Jiva has both possibility to stay either in material world or in Vaikuntha, so is called Tatastha Shakti. The transformation of Tatastha Shakti suitable to be placed in both the places. If a mathematical marginal line can be conceived in between both the places, water and land, that demarcation can be compared with Tatastha line. In between the internal potency and external potency, that demarcation can be compared with Tatastha line. Compared, be careful. In between the internal potency and external potency of Supreme Lord, there is an inconceivable place, marginal line, where Tatastha Shakti resting. I can discuss more next day. So try to understand this point. Try to understand this point that how bonded condition, mukta condition, or different, condition we can try to understand. When and how jiva become in bonded condition, this all I can discuss in different documents given by Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Anyway, kriya saktana dhik dhik vikata tapaso dhik cha jamin dhigostu brahma aham badana parifullana jaro matina kim etana sachama visayurasa matyana naro pasuno na kesanchit leso yopi oho milito gaura madhuna kriya saktana dhik dhik vikata tapaso dhik cha jamin dhigastu brahma aham badana parifullana jaro matino kim etana sachama visaya rasamatyana naro pasuna na kesanchit leso yopi ahoho milito gaura madhuna bancha kalpaturvasi ke pasindu bevacha patitanang pavana bevashna vyo namo.